Boss Hart Trucking can hold 7,000 tons of straw in each barn of this size. It gets stored here before they send it overseas to be used for animal feed.
So you'll see walking through the amount of management of just straw that we have, which is crazy. So every single one of these numbers on here represents the field it came from. So I'm gonna know who baled it and where it came from. I can literally look it up on my phone right now and know when it was baled and where it came from. And so one thing that's weird or strange, these lines over there, again, it goes back to management. We know that those lines represents what we call tops. And so if anything gets rained on in the field, then that means that it has to be looked at before we can press it because it has to be export quality. Mm-hmm. So if we move it from outside to inside, our guys are phenomenal. They're going to mark it so that it gets looked at. So even though it's dry, we have to see if there's any damage on it. So you'll see a lot of management from the field to here and seen because the goal is export quality with no weeds, no moisture damage, nothing. And of course, we live in Oregon where it rains like crazy. And so whether that's during the baling process or when it's sitting in the field, if it's sitting in the field too long, then we have to check the bottoms. So there's always this constant checking of quality that is, you know, that's not uncommon in any agricultural product. But as you go through here, I'm able to see exactly where it came from, who baled it. I can tell just by looking at what product it is, but I would be able to pull up my database on my phone, type in a few things, and it'll tell me exactly all the information I need. So technology is so useful in so many ways, and I see opportunity for that to really get better.
Technology plays a big part in getting the straw ready for shipment as well.
The bales of straw obviously are held together by twine. They're going to take off the twine, and it becomes just loose straw at that time. It's going to be put onto a conveyor belt and then basically compressed to about half its size.
Okay, wow.
So, and the reason that we go through this entire process is we're wanting to maximize the weight in the containers. And so we're able to maximize that weight in the shipping containers because of space. And so shipping internationally is expensive.
Yeah.
And those containers, and so the more weight we can put into the containers, the better freight rates we get, or the better price per ton we can get. Yep. And so once we compress it, they then make them into smaller packages, and then we put strap on top of them, or around them in order to contain them.
Take a trip to Salem, Oregon to visit Shelley and Macy, who ship one of the state's top byproducts all over the world.